Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed to us certain phrases that if we recite, the rewards are tremendous, greater than you and I can imagine. We should realize the mercy of Allah. In Surah Baqarah, verse 185, it says, Allah intends for you ease and does not intend for you hardship, and wants for you to complete the period and to glorify Allah for that to which He has guided you, and perhaps you will be grateful. Small deeds equals to big rewards. Every moment we spend in life is an opportunity we should be grateful for. Our book has not yet been concluded, and we have a chance to rewrite the script. Allah has shown us the way to Jannah, and we are all capable of making this journey. Certain du'as and prayers carry heavy rewards. Some take no longer than 10 seconds. We just have to be disciplined enough to consistently perform such acts without failure. Only then may we stand a chance on the Day of Judgment to enter Jannah. The focus of this article is to cover the benefits of reciting Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. This short phrase fits the equation small deed equals to big rewards. We will discuss the benefits of reciting Subhanallah wa bihamdihi according to the hadith. But before we do, let's first dive into the English translation of this phrase so we understand what we are saying. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi means glory be to Allah and praise Him. Subhanallah. This one word encompasses the Tawheed, the basic principles of faith in the oneness of Allah. This phrase you glorify and exalt Him to be above any fault, any partners, or any shortcomings. Sometimes you will also hear the following. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi subhanallah al-azim, meaning glory be to Allah and all praise is due to Him. Glory be to Allah the Great. The benefits of reciting Subhanallah wa bihamdihi in the hadith. Now here are the benefits mentioned according to the hadith. The summary of these hadiths are as follows. Number 1. Reciting 100 times a day will erase all sins, no matter how large. Number 2. Not only do you erase your sins, but you gain rewards for remembering Allah. Number 3. The gain of rewards is equivalent to a man reciting prayers from dawn to noon, that is if you say these words. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi adada khalqihi, wa rida nafsihi, wa zinata arshihi, wa midada kalimatihi. Forgiveness of sins by reciting 100 times a day. It was narrated by Abu Huraira, Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him, who said, whoever says Subhanallah wa bihamdihi 100 times a day will be forgiven all his sins, even if they were as much as the foam of the sea. Great rewards in remembering Allah. Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, reported, heavy in the scales are dear to the merciful. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanallah al-Azim. Glory be to Allah and He is the praise. And Allah, the greatest, is free from imperfection. Four words carrying a full day's rewards. Juwayriyah bint al-Harith, may Allah be pleased with her. The mother of the believers reported, the Prophet, peace be upon him, came out from my apartment in the morning as I was busy in performing the dawn prayer. He came back in the forenoon and found me sitting there. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, are you still in the same position as I left you? I replied in the affirmative. Thereupon the Prophet said, I recited four words 3 times after I had left you. If these are to be weighed against all you have recited since morning, these will be heavier. These are Subhanallah wa bihamdihi adada khalqihi wa rida nafsihi wa zinata arshihi wa midada kalimatihi. Allah is free from imperfection and I begin with His praise, as many times as the number of His creatures, in accordance with His good pleasure, equal to the weight of His throne, and equal to the ink that may be used in recording the words for His praise.